Hello everyone, what is happening? I'm your host Ayman Hasan and welcome back to another video here at Most Amazing Top 10. Guess who's back? Back again with another Disney video. That's right. But like with most things that seem too heartwarming or too fuzzy to be true, the same can be said for our beloved childhood Disney films. I'm sorry in advance if I semi-ruin some of these films for you, but the truth has to be heard, okay? It's not always a happily ever after, and a true love's kiss doesn't always fix everything, Prince Charming. Remember to like and subscribe, guys, and do check out Top 10 Hindi videos as well while you're at it, so you can get not one, but two doses of me right now. But without further ado, this is the top 10 real stories behind Disney movies. Starting us off at number 10 is Sleeping Beauty. I still sadly haven't seen the animated movie, but I feel like everyone knows the story so well that I basically have seen the movie. I have seen Maleficent though, if that counts. You have gorgeous Aurora having the luxury to sleep for years, which I wish I had every time I had to wake up early, but I'm not a princess, so whatever, moving on. And the only way she'll wake up is with that true love's kiss. Well, the movie I've heard is pretty eventful and dramatic. I mean, it's not exactly a rom-com, but the original story it was based on is even more horrific. The original Italian story was written in the 17th century, and the princess is called Talia, not Aurora. She pricks her finger on the spindle as per usual and falls into a deep sleep. Nothing new there, but it's not charming, sweet Philip who saves her, no. Far from it. It's a king, not even a prince, who comes to rescue her. So one, he's already a lot older than her and his kiss doesn't even wake her up, but instead he gathers the fruits of her love, meaning he basically rapes her while she's asleep. Fast forward 9 months later, she gives birth to twins and one of them sucks a splinter from her finger, huge safety hazard by the way, but sure, and she finally wakes up. She then ends up falling in love with that same king who's married, and his queen orders the twins to be abducted, cooked, and then fed to the king. Thankfully, she fails, and thankfully, this version wasn't the animated version. At number 9 is The Little Mermaid. The princess whose hair, whether wet or dry, looks like it's in a Head & Shoulders ad for the entirety of the film. I mean, seriously, who has that much volume? I'm in awe. Great hair aside, Ariel has a great heart as well. Even though the Disney version leaves her with a happily ever after, as it always does, the original story by Hans Christian Andersen doesn't really follow that trope. In the original version, Ariel still trades her voice with the sea witch, but her punishment for failing isn't just turning back into a mermaid, it's straight up death. With every step, her feet feel like they're stepping on daggers, and even after that, she still dances for Prince Eric, but to no avail. He ends up marrying another girl who he thinks saved him from the shipwreck. I mean, do your research maybe, Eric, before you marry someone? But before dying, Ariel's sisters sell their hair to bring her a dagger, saying if she kills the prince, his blood will turn her feet into fins again. But of course she can't do it, she loves him too much, and she ends up turning into sea foam at the very end. This is a perfect example of a guy leading you on and then just wasting your time. Coming in at number 8 is Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Fun fact of the day, this is actually Disney's first feature-length animated film, and if that is a well-known fact, then just disregard me trying to be knowledgeable and cool. In the Disney version, Snow White and the prince end up getting married after he awakens her with that true love's kiss, and the evil queen dies by lightning striking a cliff that she was standing on. Maybe don't stand on the cliff next time if you don't want to die? Just a suggestion, just saying. The original German story isn't too different from the animated version. Instead of asking the huntsman for Snow White's heart in a box, she asks for her liver and lungs in a box because she wants to eat them for dinner. The princess is in her glass coffin when the prince finds her, but he falls in love with her anyway even though she's technically dead, and takes her coffin away whilst doing God knows what with it and her. The apple dislodges from her throat miraculously after a year of not dislodging while she was in the coffin, and she finally wakes up. The queen has to dance at their wedding wearing hot iron shoes until she dies. Honestly, props to you, Snow White, at least you got revenge. At number 7 now is The Hunchback of Notre Dame. This is actually the second Disney movie I ever watched, and I actually used to watch it on VCR if anyone still knows what that is. I used to have to wait for the whole thing to rewind to the beginning just to watch it again, but oh my god, it was such a good film. The story itself is rife with so many issues and ups and downs and fire and death and beauty and all that is Disney, but the the original is even more morbid. The original story by Victor Hugo ends well for absolutely no one. In Disney's version, Quasimodo, our resident hunchback, and Frollo both fall in love with Esmeralda, our resident gypsy, and Quasimodo ends up killing Frollo at the end. Sorry, spoiler alert in case no one's seen it already. In Victor's version, Frollo frames Esmeralda for attempted murder and she gets sentenced to hanging. Quasimodo still does push Frollo off a roof, but that's because he's laughing at Esmeralda being hung. Sicko. He then goes to her grave and refuses to leave, so much so that he actually dies of starvation at her grave. I mean, I don't want to say he died in vain, but he could have lived. Filling in our number 6 slot is Bambi. I've never seen the film and I legitimately had no idea what the story was until I had to do this video, but at least now I know. The original book is actually an adult novel that explores complex themes about man versus nature and the circle of life, and it's not really the fuzzy, heartwarming Disney movie everyone thinks it is. During Bambi's first ever walk into the woods, he sees a mouse getting brutally killed and then overhears other animals threatening to kill each other. Then later on, a hunter shoots Bambi and a different deer, and the great prince tells him to walk in circles in order to spread his blood, so the hunter gets confused on where the bodies will end up. At the end of the movie, the great prince also shows Bambi the dead hunter to remind him that humans aren't invincible after all. Haven't watched the movie, but I hope it's not like that. At number 5 is The Fox and the Hound. Again, I didn't know anything about the plot of this film until this video, and I don't know why. I feel like this is a recurring theme. I haven't watched any of the Disney films that center around animals, but I've seen all the princess ones. I mean, what does that say about me? Well, anyway, the story is a friendship-based Tom and Jerry chase-like film wherein Copper, who becomes a hunter, hunting dog, and Chief, his owner, try and kill Todd the fox for the majority of the film, but friendship prevails. In the Daniel P. Mannix version, the fox, Todd, is raised by a hunting family, not a farmer, and then is released back into the wild. So far so good, no one's died yet. But then Todd starts taunting all the other hunting dogs as revenge, and one of them actually ends up breaking free and is hit by a train while chasing Todd. Next, Todd dies from exhaustion from the chase, and another dog also reaches his expiration, meaning he becomes too old and he also has to be shot. I just feel like three animals just died at once and it really could have all just been avoided. Coming at number 4 is Beauty and the Beast. Let me just get this out of the way. Animated version, loved it. Live action version, loved it even more. I never liked Emma Watson in any role but Hermione, but she was the perfect Belle. In the original fairy tale, it's not the Beast that's seen as evil. Belle's not actually an only child. She has two sisters, and I'd say they're the evil ones. In the original, the Beast allows Belle to go home as long as she comes back after 1 week, which are, I mean, generous conditions for a hostage. When she meets her sisters finally, they try and get her to stay home for longer by being nice to her in the hopes that the Beast would get angry and eat Belle when she returned to the castle. Belle already had bad luck with the whole being kidnapped by a Beast thing, but having mean siblings was just the cherry on top. Oh, and she's also half fairy in the original, and her and the Beast turn out to be cousins. I'll just leave you with that one. Ah, number 3 slot is Mulan. Our girl proving to everyone that girls can do everything that guys can do, and sometimes even a bit better than they can. Also, you don't need to ask me twice. Most of you are probably like, we didn't even ask you once. But yes, I'm absolutely stoked for the live action adaptation coming out next year. Let's have it. In the film, the Hans end up defeating the Huns, and Mulan ends up saving the emperor and wins the war, and then goes back home. In Hua Mulan's original poem that the movie is based off of, China actually loses the war completely. The Khan from the enemy side lets Mulan live, but only if she lives with him. So naturally, our quick-witted girl escapes from that situation ASAP. When she finally gets home, she learns that her dad died while she was away and her mum remarried. And then she proceeds to kill herself in order to be with her dad. Now number 2 is Cinderella. Oh my god, I legit just love Cinderella. I saw the cartoon so many times, I thought her dress was the most stunning thing ever. I was like, I'm gonna wear this to prom when I grow up. But let's not even talk about the live action version, because that was also on point. I mean, there are many origin Cinderella stories. One even has a love interest for her ugly stepsister, but there's no fun in choosing the boring origin story. The Brothers Grimm, on the other hand, had a much more bloody version. We're talking Game of Thrones Red Wedding level. In their version, when Prince Charming gets to Cinderella's house, her sisters both cut off some of their toes and parts of their feet in order to fit into the slipper. Pigeons swoop down to show the prince the blood, because apparently he couldn't see the red blood in a transparent glass slipper, and he realizes they're phonies. Then, as if the sisters haven't been through enough, some birds come and peck out of their eyes during Cinderella's wedding. I mean, I know they're not nice girls, but the brothers Grimm literally have zero mercy. Finally, at our number one spot is Pinocchio. Considering I haven't seen the movie, Pinocchio is probably the Disney movie I know the least about in terms of story. Literally, all I know is that his nose grows when he lies. In the film, Pinocchio and his friend Jiminy Cricket end up transforming him into a real boy, but the story's original writer Carlo Collodi had a whole different idea about what was going on. He actually created the story for Italian newspapers to show kids what could happen to them if they behaved badly. In his story, Pinocchio is naughty and cruel and is constantly tortured throughout the story for bad behavior. Jiminy Cricket is called the Talking Cricket in his story, and after trying to give him some good advice, Pinocchio ends up killing him with a mallet. In the original, Pinocchio gets hung and dies, but since fans loved him so much, Collodi kept him alive and just continued to torture him some more. A bit sadistic, don't you think? And that is it for today's video, guys. I hope your view of all these films is still intact, maybe a bit more informed, but still intact. Let me know what your favorite Disney film is in the comments below, and also tell me which real story you'd never heard of before. As always, guys, remember to like and subscribe to this channel and Top 10 Hindi as well. But without further ado, I'm your host, Ayman Hasan, and I'll see you next time. Bye!